And I'm going to talk about the bacteria which are very, very innocuous, and at times they can give us some health benefit. So this is, I call them probiotic bacteria. So I start with, we know from the very beginning that the microorganisms are related with most of the type of foods, or it is drinks, or they are also related to the health in many ways. Like when the people discovered lactic acid bacteria means those bacteria which are found in the food like dahi. When the milk is kept for some time or for 1 day or 2 days, it converts into dahi. So that conversion is because of this group of bacteria which are called as lactic acid bacteria. And I'm going to talk about this group of bacteria only. So the Theodore S. series, he was the first person to describe that our digestive tract, they also harbor a lot many bacteria within them, and it is an ecosystem in itself. And in fact, the number of bacteria which is present in our digestive tract is more than the number of our own cells. And later on, because the more and more interest grew on what this bacteria can do, later on, Henry Tessier, he found that he observed the bacteria isolated from the infants who were fed with the breast, or they were fed with the mother's milk. And in those infants, the intestinal diseases or the gastrointestinal offsets were less compared to the formula fed infants. So he proposed that, okay, the formula, this group of bacteria which are present in the breastfed infants, they have an important role of flushing out the bacteria which causes gastrointestinal disorders. So he gave some indication of that bacteria can be used in a useful way. Then later on, Mesnikov, he even wrote a book called as The Prolongation of Life, meaning that how the bacteria can be used to prolong the life, and his observation was based on the Bulgarian people who used to consume this milk a lot. So from this observation, he said that, okay, this group of bacteria which are present in the fermented milk, they have an important role and they can prolong the life. That, and in fact, that was the best selling book of his time. And he gave the more solid indication that this bacteria can have an important health benefit. And later on, by seeing this result, many people investigated, okay, in what way the bacteria, if they have to provide some health benefit, they should enter into the digestive tract and they should live and colonize in the intestinal intestine, and then only they will impart health benefit. But later on, it was found that many of the bacteria cannot survive during the passage through this intestinal tract. So because the stomach is very acidic, so whenever bacteria enters into the stomach, most of them will be killed. So people started, okay, what are the bacteria which survives through this intestinal tract? Then later on found this lactobacillus acidophilus was found that which can survive through this passage. And though this was discovered in around 1900, but this its popularization was done by the one of the professor at Yale University. And later on, in Germany, this lactobacillus acidophilus along with bifidus, these two bacteria were used to prepare dahi. They call it bio yogurt. Okay, it's like dahi only, but in those countries, it is called as a bio yogurt. And later on, this lactobacillus kg was discovered by Dr. Sirota, and this is used to prepare a Yakult product, and it is still in the market, and even in India also this product is still today also. And so then what are probiotic? what to have a probiotic effect, what should be the character. The WHO has also intervened on this. So WHO has said that if any bacteria or any food needs to be claimed with probiotic, then it should provide at least one health benefit, any health benefit which can be proven. So what are the health benefits which can be provided by this kind of bacteria? Like in case of acute diarrheal infections, like rotaviral infections, which happens in the small children or in some immunocompromised patients. Like when studies were done in among the children using this particular group of bacteria, which is lactobacillus rhamnosus, then the rate of the duration of diarrheal infections was cut down for 2-3 days. Again, in another studies which was done using lactobacillus enteri, in this also the duration of diarrhea was cut down by about 5 days. So that means effectively this group of bacteria can prevent, they can cut down the duration of diarrheal infections to some extent. Then and the other issue is this can be used in antibiotic associated diarrhea or antibiotic induced diarrhea. Like most of the patients who are treated with antibiotics, almost 20% of they suffer from diarrhea because of this antibiotic treatment. So though the actual cause why this diarrhea happens is not known, but it has been proven that many of the microorganisms like Saccharomyces or some lactobacillus or some bifidobacteria, they can prevent this antibacterial diarrhea and antibiotic associated diarrhea if administered along with the antibiotic. Some probiotic microorganisms, they have even been implicated in reduction of the hypertension, like usually this angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2, and this angiotensin 2 can also bind to the bradykinin, which is a vasodilator. So vasodilator will not be available. At the same time, angiotensin 2 is a vasoconstrictor, so it increases the blood pressure. Now, and this is done by this conversion is done by the ACE enzyme. Now this ACE enzyme can be inhibited by the peptide which is synthesized, which will be formed during fermentation with lactobacillus helveticus. And again, that means this lactobacillus can peptide which is synthesized by the lactobacillus helveticus can prevent this conversion, or it can reduce the hypertension. Like many studies have been done on the reduction of cholesterol also, and there are many mechanisms how the bacteria can reduce the cholesterol. And one of the mechanism is through this bile salt hydrolase enzyme, which is synthesized by the bacteria only, not in the this enzyme is not synthesized by the humans. So so this enzyme will convert the bile enzyme into some it will deconjugate, and the deconjugated bile can easily flush out along with the stool. And when this sort of bile, deconjugated bile are flushed out, then there will be need for more and more cholesterol for synthesis synthesis of bile. So in that way, the this bacteria can also be utilized in reduction of serum cholesterol. Similarly, in many studies has been done, though many of these studies are in the lab scale only, involving either mice or cell lines. Nevertheless, this bacteria has been shown to have some potential against different types of cancer also. Like as I said, the fermented milk, we can ferment the milk either using probiotic bacteria, or when we ferment with probiotic bacteria, the milk protein will convert into different type of bioactive peptides. So bioactive peptides on itself can also have the antibacterial property, antiviral property, or strengthens immune system, anti hypertensive activity, or opioid or anti-opioid properties. So in summary, this is the summary what a probiotic bacteria can do. Like it can have neurological effect, immunological effect, endocrinal effect, production of specific bioactive peptides, vitamin synthesis, bile salt metabolism, direct antagonism, enzymatic activity, gut barrier reinforcement, neutralization of carcinogens, and colonization resistance. So many activities are there in this group of bacteria, which are called as a probiotic bacteria. Thank you.